What you're going to learn today is how to use HumanIK to improve the look and feel of games featuring vehicles. This is a wide topic and a very interesting one. Here are the precise points we will focus on today. Let's begin by talking about the steering wheel and how we can manipulate it. First thing we need is a 3D vehicle. For the first part of this presentation, we will focus on the seat and the driving wheel. Soon you will understand how important it is to properly tag your 3D assets. Then we need a character. Here is Sven. I already described the characterization process in a previous video, so I will not cover this here again. I assume the character here is already characterized, and for this example, we also need a proper fingers characterization. This is the only authored FK animation we will be using. It is a basic sitting animation coming from a motion capture source. It is a bit shaky, the motion capture data seems unstable, but anyway, we will take advantage of this glitch to simulate vehicle vibrations. First, you need to make sure that the FK data is playing correctly when the character is seated on its vehicle. We are going to use HumanIK for the character to grab the steering wheel. How are we going to do this? Let's do some prototyping inside Motion Builder. First, I make sure I'm using the HumanIK character solver here. Just by moving one effector in the scene, HumanIK is able to update the whole limb transformations chain and even the full body pose if the effector position moves further away. You can both translate and rotate the effectors. The problem here is that the target is going to move. During the game, the steering wheel is going to rotate. We need to find a way to somehow tag the steering wheel so that HumanIK knows where exactly to grab it. In order to do this, we get back in Motion Builder and use the transformation manipulators to properly position the left wrist of the character so that it looks like the hand holds the steering wheel at frame 0. I'm moving a bit that one. This looks good. I'm adjusting on all axes. And also we will move each finger effector one by one to get a realistic hand pose. This is a bit tedious, but the result we will obtain is going to look very nice. Also note, these are the high LOD settings we are doing here. When running the low LOD solver, fingers won't be taken into account for performance reasons. So what we are doing here is mainly relevant to the player character and to the characters being close to the camera. We shall not forget to adjust the turn here. Okay, here we are. This looks nice. Now we need to do the same posing operation with the right arm. I need to rotate the wrist effector a bit. This looks good enough now. I'm going to just skip the finger posing here. Great. This looks like a realistic pose. But the problem is, when the steering wheel rotates, the hands stick to frame zero pose and do not behave as expected. There is no way to directly parent or attach effectors to 3D objects in Motion Builder. What we have to do to solve this is to use what we call auxiliary effectors by clicking here on the character tool and creating an auxiliary effector. In the viewport, auxiliary effectors appears as yellow cubes. And the nice thing with auxiliary effector is you can parent them and align them to any object in the scene. So what I'm doing here is I'm parenting the two wrist auxiliary effectors to the steering wheel object. And see, as soon as I start rotating the wheel, the arms and hands behave as expected. So this looks pretty good as a first result when blended with the initial FK data. But if you look close enough, you will notice there is something wrong. I will try to show this in Motion Builder. Here, we see when the left arm reaches full extension, the hand does not hold tight to the steering wheel. See the small offset? This is because HumanIK is still working in simple IK mode. We have to activate the full body IK solver here. We do this by just increasing the pull values for the wrist auxiliary effectors. Here, I'm increasing the pull value, and do you see how the character immediately reacts? It is reacting a bit too much to my sense, so I'm going to reduce a bit the resist value for the elbows, since it appears HumanIK is trying to preserve the FK angles a bit too much. Okay, this looks way better. Please remember, this setup is totally dynamic and HumanIK will be able to adapt to any vehicle layout. If the distance between the driver's seat and the steering wheel changes between vehicle types, HumanIK will be able to compute good-looking results anyway. Also, HumanIK can easily adapt to different character setups. Shall we invite this nice-looking guy here that is slightly taller than Sven? He also has longer arms and longer legs, and for some reason he only has four fingers. Even if the skeletal structure of these two characters is pretty different, HumanIK is able to compute nice looking results without changing the IK settings we made here. What we do is we simply call the retargeting solver before calling the full body IK solver. Here I'm going to display both the original skeleton in yellow and the retargeted skeleton in gray. To summarize, here's what we did to get there. We needed three things. First, a simple sitting FK animation. Then, a vehicle that was precisely tagged using the auxiliary effectors in Motion Builder. Finally, the HumanIK solver is able to process these FK and IK inputs and produce a good-looking output pose. I will not discuss all the C++ code you have to write to get to this point. Please take a look at the video named Integration on our YouTube channel. It covers in details all the basic C++ steps that are still relevant to this driving example. The C++ initialization sequence, for example, does not require any change. We are still creating a character from a characterization file, then creating a character state to hold the input and output poses, then creating an effector set state, and finally a property set state. But the main loop sequence is now a bit more sophisticated. First, we set up the effectors for both the left and the right wrist. We retrieve the target positions and orientations from the game engine vehicle object. Then, when the character is close to the camera, we do some high LOD setup. We set target positions and orientations for each fingers in the hands, and then call the solver. Finally, when the character is further away from the camera, we simply call the low LOD solver. Let's move forward and see how we can improve the visual appeal of our driver character. Following the same principles we described for the steering wheel and the character's hands, we can attach the character's feet to the acceleration and brake pedals. Also, what I did here to improve the quality of the animation is I activated feet floor contact. This improves the behavior of the character's heel and avoids nasty geometry overlaps. In order to initialize the floor contact, you need to expose to HumanIK some metrics regarding your feet. HumanIK has no way of knowing about the feet skin width of your character and the type of shoes it is wearing. Then you simply need to activate the floor contact for the feet, first line of code here, and update the contact plane transforms at each frame. Another effect you can implement is connecting the chest, the hips, and the head effectors to your physics engine so that the character solving takes into account accelerations. This can look pretty nice, especially when an accident occurs. Here is the same sequence in slow motion. This is an example we've wrapped up quite quickly and it is far from looking perfect. You can get much better looking behavior by also connecting the knees and the elbow effectors to the physics. It is up to you to experiment. Please try to play with this. I'm now going to conclude this session with a simple use case. Using everything we learned until this point, I'm going to show you how HumanIK can help a character to push a vehicle. So here is the problem we have. The initial position and orientation of the character relatively to the vehicle depends on the accuracy of the pathfinding solutions that dropped him here. We know the character is close to the vehicle, but it might be misaligned with the car main axis, and we cannot exactly predict the distance between the character and the vehicle. Since we only have one push animation, but many vehicle types in our games, it also might be that the contact point between the character's arms and the car is not at the right height. So if we naively play the push animation at this point, things can look very bad. Here is how this problem needs to be solved. First, using the auxiliary effectors helper in Motion Builder, you should tag your car. Here I tagged it with two potential push points for each character's hand. Then, starting from your current FK pose, you should progressively increase the reach in translation, reach in rotation and pull values for both characters' hands effectors. This progressively activates the full body IK solver and the character's hand will be attached to the vehicle. You can see here that the solver can adapt to a wide range of setups and does not rely on any fixed distance orientation between the character and the vehicle here. Then you simply need to continue playing your push animation with the IK fully on, and things should look as expected with HumanIK guaranteeing precise hand contacts.